For this next problem, we're going to be looking at some tricky behavior of O notation when we're dealing with numbers. To illustrate this, let's take a look at the number 4,000. Now, 4,000 has a magnitude, a size of, well, 4,000. But you can write it down with a lot less than 4,000 digits. In fact, you can write it down with, well, 1, 2, 3, 4 digits. So it's actually a logarithmic number of digits in relation to the size of the number. Similarly, if we wanted to write down 40,000, which is 10 times as big as 4,000, we only need to write down, well, 5 digits. So the number of digits is growing logarithmically with the size of the number that we want to represent. Now, let's say we call the actual number we want to represent n. And let's say the number of digits necessary to represent n we'll call d. And now let's take a look at a fairly simple algorithm to test whether n is prime. So we have this basic isPrime function that tests whether n is prime, and does this by first checking if n is less than 2, since 0 and 1 are not prime, and returning false in that case. If n equals 2, then we return true because 2 is prime. And then we get rid of all the even numbers because none of the even numbers other than 2 are prime. And then we check if there are any odd numbers between 3 and the square root of n that divide n, because if there are any numbers that divide n, then it's not prime. And it turns out, to check for primality, you actually only need to check up to the square root of n. And we're not going to get into why that is the case right now because, well, that's another course. But if it finds any numbers that divide n, then we return false, and otherwise we fall all the way through this and return true. So my first question is, which of these answers best characterize the asymptotic running time of this primality algorithm as a function of n, the value of the input size? Is it constant order, logarithmic? Is it on the order of the square root of n? Is it linear, quadratic, or does it turn out that this is exponential? And my second question is, what about if we express the running time as a function of d, the number of digits that it takes to represent the number, rather than as a function of n, the actual value of the number? If we express the running time in this way, then is it linear in the number of digits, quadratic? Does it grow to the 10th power? Does it grow to 10 to the log of d? 10 to the d over 2, 10 to the square root of d, or 10 to the d? Check whichever one is best.